Chinese answer to the challenges of equal development in the world. It's indeed a powerful platform that anchors our close cooperation with China, unquote. Therefore, Ethiopia's attached emphasis to these far-sighted and multifaceted initiatives. Ethiopia is a gateway for Africa. It's the seat of the African Union, the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa, and over 120 embassies and international organizations located in Ethiopia. It has a population of over 105 million, of which 70% is the young population. Ethiopia, with a population of approximately 105 million and a rapidly growing middle-class society, is the second largest market in Africa and is also part of the common market for East and Southern Africa, comprising 19 countries and over 400 million people. The capital, Addis Ababa, is the main hub for air transport and the home of Ethiopia's airline, which have won repeated recognition as the best airline in Africa. Ethiopia is currently undertaking massive socio-economic transformation. On the political front, it has widened the political space, freed political prisoners, amended draconian laws as the charities and society law, the media law, and the anti-terrorist law that have stifled citizens from expression of their ideas and from freely associating with each other. On the economic side, a major transformation is taking shape. The government has decided to fully and partially privatize state-owned enterprises and parastatals. Again, the government of Ethiopia has recently formulated homegrown economic reform. The basic tenets of the homegrown economic reforms are to leverage the achievements of the last decade for high quality growth, the need to overcome emerging challenges and create new opportunities, sustaining the success of the past decade by correcting emerging macroeconomic imbalances, easing structural bottlenecks, and create new opportunities and sources of growth. Finally, the need to upgrade our policy and institutional framework so that to be able to take our success to the next level. Ethiopia is a major beneficiary in the Belt and Road Initiative. As His Excellency Dr. Abiy Ahmed said, Prime Minister said, we are inspired by the Chinese leadership and its Belt and Road Initiative. We have good reasons behind it. Projects such as the Addis Ababa Railway Standard Gauge is part of a Belt and Road Initiative, are essential for the economic progress and prosperity of the two countries. They are more than economic relations. By the way, the economic link between Djibouti and Ethiopia is by far well developed. Now the trade volume is highly increasing because of the development of the railway. And also the corridor is currently becoming a very competent corridor in terms of the cost and the flow of goods from Ethiopia to the port of Djibouti. By allowing us to trade together with Djibouti and other neighboring countries, these projects make each country a stakeholder in the peace and prosperity of the other. Since the country has embarked on expanding its infrastructure network across the nation, the technical as well as financial support from the China government has played a greater role. The recently inaugurated Addis Ababa Djibouti 756 fully electrified standard gauge railway is helping the country to easily transport its commodity through the port of Djibouti. Similarly, railway construction projects are underway in different parts of the country. We have another huge railway project in the northern part of the country which connects Ethiopia to Djibouti, and also we have a plan to develop another railway line between Ethiopia and the port of Eritrea, maybe in the coming few years. Ethiopia, through its vision of becoming a middle-income country by 2025, and to bring structural transformation in its economy, has launched an ambitious plan of constructing 12 industrial parks across the nation. Major Chinese companies have participated in the construction of these industrial parks, and even some Chinese companies are constructing their own industrial parks in Ethiopia. The Chinese companies are not only participating in the construction of the industrial parks in Ethiopia, but they are also taking part in textile, garment, leather, and leather product manufacturing, among others. Ethiopia has a plan to have 30 industrial parks by 2025. I hereby would like to call up on those competent companies to actively engage in this endeavor, either through constructing the industrial park or by leasing the shed, would participate in manufacturing different products. Another growth potential that Ethiopia endowed with is the energy sector. It has a potential of generating 45,000 megawatts of hydroelectric power, 40,000 megawatts of wind power, 5,000 to 7,000 megawatts of geothermal power. We are inviting investors to jointly develop this huge environmentally friendly energy potential. Ethiopia, for the first time in its history, will launch an Earth orbiting satellite on 17 December 2019 at 6 p.m. Ethiopian time. The satellite will be blast off into space from China with its ground station located in Ethiopia at the Toto Space Observatory facility. The main purpose of this 70-kilogram Earth observing satellite is for the monitoring of agriculture, water, climate, environment, and mining. The manufacturing of the satellite and continuous training of Ethiopian space engineers is partly funded by the Chinese government. Finally, I wish you all to have a successful deliberation. I would like to thank once again the Belt and Road Institute of Sweden for organizing this forum and inviting all us to participate. I thank you.